Make things easy. Oh, that makes things a lot better. Yeah. Well, even if you, like, raise it up to the ceiling, it'll help. This shouldn't be this difficult.
Do you want to be using the computer that's not in
here? I figured this would be good enough for this. I think it is. It's warm enough. Oh wow, that's wonderful. That looks so much better than it seems like it should. Man. Okay, that's fine. Technically, yeah, but I haven't posted it, so no one knows. Alright, I don't know if anyone's watching yet, but I'll be ready in a sec, so, it's still just running the background stuff. I've watched these cinematics a couple times, so, there's a lot of that. The game certainly has a lot of personality right out of the gate, so that's pretty cool. Sorry, because of the way that YouTube does its stuff, I actually need to watch the stream myself on another screen. It's kind of All right, so oh hey, there are already comments. Man, okay. Alright, cool. Wow, I got people here. Alright, neat. So, I assume that you guys will tell me if something goes wrong, like you can't hear me or something. So, yeah. So, yeah, I guess we're about to get started. So, just some, basic prefacing information. This is actually the first time I've done any streaming stuff. I don't usually talk when I play games, so it'll be interesting to see how this works out. But, you know, I'm gonna try, see what happens. And in any case, it's my first time playing the game, so it'll be good to, you know, it's a bit of game culture that I'm kind of missing, so. Yeah. Alright, let's get started then. Whoa. go sleeping. I like sleeping. I forget how, when was this made in relation, like, Ocarina of Time or something, because I guess the graphics do look very similar. Dingpot? Is Dingpot actually a thing? That sounds like a weird insult. Alright, that's a good way of looking at it. More power to you, mysterious witch. Really? I mean... I'll admit, going into this, I did not expect, I did not expect Snow White to be a major thing it'd be referencing, except also that the person more beautiful than her is a squirrel or something. Okay. Okay. I'll admit, for platformers at the time, it's kind of a unique set of... She's gonna kidnap her and then I need to save her, isn't she? Okay, it's kind of a unique reason. Oh. I don't know, I think the mole is cuter. The giant glasses. I don't know. It's kind of silly and adorable. Oh, so the character I'm playing is lazy. That I can relate to this already, actually. I'm okay with this. And 5 months before. Oh, okay, I see. Wow. Oh, and people are staying here instead of their streams. I kind of like being able to see what people are saying. That's fun. Oh? Man, I love these old games and their weird gibberish for voice acting. It's great. Kind of like Animal Crossing is better than this, but it's Animal Crossing. Okay, I could see a lot of the... She talking rhyme the entire game? Because that's awesome. I also like that my character just slept through all of that. It's probably gonna seem kind of pretentious trying to find narrative meaning in a game like this, but that's a really good character defining moment in any case. It's a great introduction to him. Okay. Oh, so she did actually take her. Okay, yep, that's... Alright, well... Oh my gosh, wait, what? Oh, right, okay, got it. Just trying to get a hold of the controls. Whoa, that's a tiny jump, I feel like, for a game like this. Sorry for the... for yet more Animal Crossing references, but I really want him to yell at me right now about not turning the game off. I like how Banjo's sound, when he's talking, just sounds like he's really confused. Hey, that is a comma splice game. Comma splice. What was that? Yeah, that'd be great. Geeky. Well. Wow. Oh, okay, good. Thank you. Alright, well. Bottles. I forget, is that actually his name? Or did they make up a nickname for him? No. Oh, okay. Just another one somewhere around? I can't seem to control the camera at all. Which, you know. Oh, okay. Okay. Worm. Kazooie's kind of a... You know, I'm starting to get the feeling Jack and Daxter was super inspired by this. I can see the... Oh, okay, that makes sense. That's actually a fair point. Hey, no. I figured that... Okay, you know what? I knew the jump higher thing, because every game does that, but for some odd reason I hadn't been holding... Shut up, guys. I know what I'm doing. Oh, it gives me a double jump right out the gate, huh? That's kind of nice. Oh, of sorts. All right. Man, I'm not sure if I miss these old-timey tutorials, you know, where they spent so long explaining, like, oh, press these buttons. Just break the fourth wall a bunch and I'll tell you how it all works. Oh no. See, this is the thing, I'm not used to talking in the stream. I don't know what he just said. Can I talk to him again? Okay, cool. Alright, cool. Okay, got it. Oh, and Grunty doesn't rhyme in the sequel? That's unfortunate. Sorry, I'm apparently needing to refresh this every time I want to see new comments. That's kind of annoying. If it keeps doing that, I might just go over to Twitch. I just really liked that I could keep it all in one place. So, that's... Oh, okay, bottles. Okay, cool. Okay. I don't know what that ring thing over there is, but I want it and probably can't jump over to it from here. Nope. Can I just jump in? Nope. Oh, no, wait. No, wait. Yes! I got a... honeycomb? Oh. Oh, okay. So they're... Okay, so they're pieces of heart, basically. Oh, right, I'm searching for more molehills, so probably that way. I wonder, can I swim? Cool, I can see. Oh, you know what? I guess I actually saw that in the... Oh, no. I guess I actually saw that in the... what's it? Oh, man. I love how much better we've gotten at water effects. I mean, of course, you know, for its time, the visuals are fine. And the design is actually... I mean, you know, the characters are designed well and stuff. It's always fun going back a bit in time, you know. Oh, hey. Oh no, you'll get wet by swimming. No, Banjo, don't do it. No, but the bird wants to swim? I don't know about this. This is sketchy. Come on, my picture is covering that. Okay, I'm just gonna have fun trying to figure it out. Let's see. All right, got it. Okay. Oh, Kazooie's a girl? Now that's interesting. I honestly wouldn't have expected that. That's pretty cool, though. Ah, no! No! Stop. I like how the music changes in the water. No! So this is, I guess, what a lot of the stream's gonna be, guys, is just me clearly failing and stuff and getting people's heads colliding with walls. No! Yes. Okay. And I managed not to do it. I managed to do it before I drowned. And up. Aw, poor Banjo was gasping for breath. Okay, let's refresh this and see what you guys have said while I was farting around. Yes, I've heard a lot about the music, and for that matter, I've heard some of the music, you know, out of context, which I normally don't do. I normally just wait to, you know, hear it in context, but it's some great music. It's a lot of fun. I'd put it up there with, like, Crash Bandicoot. At least I really loved the early Crash Bandicoot soundtracks. But then there are a lot of, these are both platformers of the same era, and so there are a lot of sensible comparisons to be made there. So do I need to look for another molehill, or do I need to talk to him at that one again? Oh no, I didn't mean to do that. Okay, yeah, I got that. So I guess at this point I'm just looking for the next one. Oh, hey. Oh! Okay, it's just that it's an old game and it wasn't loading the molehill far enough away. Man, that's, I remember popping. It was special. And yes, Corey, we can stream to YouTube, apparently, so. And yes, Travis, they do, you know, break the fourth wall sometimes, but oftentimes they'll keep the dialogue in the game to, you know, talking about what you're doing in the context of the game, and then have, like, small button prompts. I guess they figure people are familiar enough with games now that when a little thing says R to shoot, for instance, people know what they're doing. So, you know, they usually try and be a little more subtle about it. And to be fair, this kind of tutorial isn't the super most interesting or effective, but it does work. I guess we kind of move past it in terms of modern design, but... Man, Kazooie's just being a real jerk to this guy. Alright. Control stick to... Oh, okay, so I can climb trees. I can... Yeah, I guess bears can climb trees. Oh, man. Oh, and I could just pop up out on top of it. That's cool. I missed what he just said again. I feel like it has a bunch of different camera modes. Oh, okay, there we go. Oh my gosh, there's a thing over there. Is one above me too? No. I must climb that tree. I mean, I haven't run into a situation where I need life at all yet, but... Oh, hey, that's... My cat just continues to want to be involved in my show, it seems. Yeah. Ah, man. I really miss controlling the camera with the right stick. Oh, that puts me all the way back, so, like, do I... Oh, no. That was close. Maybe the next one's up here. That'd be kind of impressive, I guess, that he dug a tunnel, like, under that little moat and then all the way up here. So let's find out if he did that. I would be impressed with... Bottles? That's his name, right? Bottles? Yes! Wow, that's a... Oh, wow. I kind of figured the whole witch head thing would be, like, the last... Whack? Okay. Oh. Oh my gosh, game. Comma splices. Those comma splices. I mean, I'm not a, you know, it's not like this is the worst game ever because it has poor grammar or anything, but I do have an English degree, so I gotta point it out at least. Okay, so I guess, I mean, there was that one other place I could, let's see if this works! Okay, considering he said uh-oh there, I'm gonna assume that there's fall damage and I should never do that again. Got it. Man, I really wish these comments updated in real time. Kazooie's a jerk to everyone? Yeah, that's what I'm noticing. Yeah, I'm looking forward, I mean, you know, I assume after this I'll play through Banjo-Tooie. If a lot of people like the stream, then maybe I'll stream it too. We'll see. And yeah, Kazooie's a jerk to everyone, that makes sense. Oh man, yeah, Travis. Yeah, the C buttons. Man. That gaming. Oh no! You know, it occurs to me it's been a little while since I've played platform. Oh no, I actually just played through Sly Cooper and the Thievish Raccoonus for the first time, so I shouldn't be quite this rusty when it comes to platforming. Yeah! Okay. Ah, no. Can I even do that? I don't understand how I'm supposed to do that. Oh man, I like how I could see like the lines to his left. That's all right. I'm just gonna try. I don't get the feel. Oh no, I can double jump. Okay, right. I keep forgetting. Oh hey, it's a little. Yeah. Yes, it's a life. Okay, cool. So trophies fashioned after Banjo means life. Okay. I don't feel like going off a waterfall. So what molehill did I miss? I missed a molehill somewhere. I mean, I have to have. But... Yeah. Oh man, I can just hold the camera button and... Okay, man. I just love those flowers going pop, pop, pop into existence over there. Oh, I didn't get up there. Probably up there I need to go. You said this was before Ocarina of Time. I guess that makes sense. Like, Ocarina of Time was really excellent about pop-in. There was still some of it, but, you know, for the most... You go into Hyrule Field and you can't actually see everything, and it's crazy. So, but really that was a problem throughout this entire generation, even a little bit into, you know, PS2 and that whole era. I'm just glad it's not an issue now. Where in the claws? Oh man, I can attack things now. Cool. Now that you know how to jump around, now learn how to murder things. That's important. Hey, hey, no, just a grammar Nazi. Come on. Imagine the Bioshock episode would probably have been a lot different if I was coming at it from a Nazi perspective. Oh man! Wait, what? Well, like, oh, we need something to help you learn how to attack. Oh hey, there's a friend of mine! Smack him with your claws! This is a carrot. A living carrot. Do we get to find out more about this world? Like, living animals I can accept, but now we have living carrots. Do they still eat carrots? Like, what about herbivores? This could be very I'm just gonna hit him. Wait, what? Oh no, I'm pushing. What is happening? I don't... Okay. Does that just mean that I've learned it, I guess? Like, I kind of expected something else to be said. Okay, grabbing ledges. That was a really common improvement in games around this, this time is really weird. No, Travis, I'm actually using a, 360 controller, which is why control things are confusing. It really... Oh, okay, so it must be the right thing. I just bounce off the carrot for some reason instead of actually attacking him. And, that's my wife around, by the way. She's doing stuff, because I'm playing this on, you know, the TV in the living room, so. Alright, well, I'm gonna say that that probably means I've learned everything, and so I'll go and head straight into the witch's hideout, apparently. Oh, I did move on. Oh, no! What have you done?
I'm broken.
My stream is forever ruined.
I'm so
okay.
Sorry, streamers.
Alright. What the... Are those eyes? Why do those rocks have eyes? Isn't that a movie? Like, The Hills Have Eyes or something, I guess? It is weird. Oh, dang it, I was refreshing so I could see the comments, and then... Nope, I'm gonna talk to him again, see what he has to say. Beak barge. Okay. Oh, okay. Oh. Oh my gosh! Jam jars? Am I killing these weird rock creatures? They're not doing anything to me. Look at them. They're all peaceful and stuff. I'm not doing that. I feel uncomfortable with this morally. This bear is deplorable. Alright, let's see if I can head up there yet. I learned how to use the beak thing, so... I like that one of his attacks first includes cowering. Like, it makes sense, you know, he gets out of the way and then Kazooie goes, wah, but still, I find that funny. Might have found it funnier, I guess, if he was established to be a coward, but I guess he's not a coward, he's just lazy. I wonder if the... Well, I guess I'll look forward to, seeing if, What? What did I miss? Do any of you guys who've played it remember, like, where I need to go? I'm missing something. Anyway, yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing if the whole game has, you know, this kind of... Oh my gosh. There you go. This kind of folky sound of the soundtrack, or... What? It would fit. It'd certainly fit. So that's the problem. I get the feeling I've probably looked at a lot of different places that are where I need to be, but the hills. Let's see. I don't think I've visited this one yet. No, I did. This is the one where he taught me how to climb trees. Yeah, okay. Let's see if you guys said anything. Wait, what? No. I'm sorry, guys. For killing the rocks. I know it was horrible. I now recognize the error of my ways, and I have repented from them. Banjo will visit a confessional in the DLC or something. I need to push B on the carrot. I totally press B on the carrot. Okay, where was the carrot? Oh, really? Does it? Is it okay? Do you need it? Okay. Where's... Oh my gosh, I ran all the way around this area instead of just going to the carrot. And Travis, it's telling me that I'm dropping some frames sometimes, but I haven't gotten any, like, huge issues. Yeah, here, just a sec, guys. I'm gonna make a quick switch. I'm watching the... comments on this iPad. It's also what the camera's clipped onto, but it's my wife's telling me that her tablet laptop thing is refreshing it automatically, and I won't need to refresh it all the time to see what you guys are telling me. So here, let me do this real quick. Yeah, you stay over there and think about what you've done, iPad. Here, you guys get to look at my ceiling for a second. Tell it's my first time trying to stream. All right. Where are the... Oh, hey, the comments are over there. Okay, cool. All right. Cool. So, let's get back to it. So, let's see. Kill the... What? Kill the... And all the rock... do I need to kill all the rock creatures? But they're random innocent things. And the carrot, too? He named the... Like, he called the carrot by name. Oh, whoa. What... That. I'm just gonna keep making Animal Crossing jokes. Who put the pitfall here? Okay, sorry, I'm done. Well. Oh, so I need to be like further away from it, I guess? I was pressing the button as I approached it. So, okay. Oh, I pressed that button before that guy even popped out. Okay. Fearsome forward roll. Okay. Yeah. Yep. Roll by running and pressing B. Okay. Okay, so I can swipe things with my claws or run into them. Okay. Aw, poor Kazooie. Except that you're kind of a jerk, so I'm not feeling too bad for you. What is with these two? Like, they introduced each other before, so I kind of assumed that they already know each other. But... rather that they don't know each other, but they'd just be trading jabs like old friends. Also, I was distracted talking about it. This is the thing I need to get better at. If I'm going to be streaming, I need to be able to actually focus on stuff while I'm talking about it. This is why I write crazy long analyses instead of streaming. Oh, no. No, come on. I just want to talk to you. Fine. Anyone know what he said? It's not letting me talk to him again, and I'm not sure what to do now. What was that? Oh, yeah. Oh, no. Ah. I'm not a fan of the whole you can't move and punch thing. This didn't stop updating, did it? Because... not seeing any. If they're helping me, I don't know. Oh! Was that it? No? Jump and B, okay. Oh, I thought it was a big thing bouncing around. My depth perception on that was completely off. Okay. Okay. I see. Oh, hey, a thing! Yes. My thing. Alright, that was... I've been playing too many high-def games lately, I guess. Yeah, I tell you, it can actually be pretty disorienting, you know? Like, going from... Oh no, there are enemies now. Going from, you know, modern high-definition games back to old ones like this. I've never been too big a fan of complaining about that, but it is a bit disorienting sometimes. Okay, no. Kill this onion thing. Nope, I'm gonna suck at killing that onion. There we go. Oh, hey! No! 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 I want you... No. Turn around... No, put the camera behind him. That's what that button does. What is this thing? I don't know what I want. It's probably more health. Yep, it's more health, and I'm okay. Cool. I never needed that at all. You know, I kind of want to see, like, a video or something where Banjo is doing that. Like, remember that creepy honeycomb guy from commercials when we were kids? When my generation was kids? I don't know. Okay, I could see that. Well, for that matter, now that I think about it, I'm sure there are a lot of, like, crossover fan art pictures of, like, Banjo and Winnie the Pooh or something. I'd watch that crossover. Or play it. A for short strokes, B for large strokes. Oh, come on, don't shudder at it. Banjo would spend the whole time sleeping, and Pooh would spend the whole time eating honey. It'd be like a sitcom. Now think of a Winnie the Pooh sitcom. Okay. Oh, okay, so he just... Oh, so he, like, gives advice or whatever the whole time, I guess. So I guess the whole game is taking place inside of here? I'll admit I'd kind of expected... I don't know, like, the usual pattern... Oh, and there she... Okay, I'm assuming this is just all a prologue or something, because if I'm running into her immediately, something's different. Or it's just a cutscene that takes... Okay, never mind. 2D old? Okay, got it. I thought she was using 2D as an adjective there. I'll be 2D old. Oh. Not that she doesn't even fit in there. I feel like this plan isn't too well thought out. Like, I'll put myself into the body of a frail young girl. That'll be great. Point taken, actually. Yeah, my wife brought up a parallel to one of the quests from the first Dragon Age, and that's a fair point. I guess the girl probably isn't much frailer than her old body, so... Oh, wow, there is a weird face in that, and it's kind of freaking me out, so I'm gonna... Alright. This looks interesting. Oh, man, another random thing to collect. I like how all these things I collect are apparently alive and explain themselves. Oh, bye, Travis. You're probably gone already, but bye. And yeah, hey, if you look it up on the internet, I'm sure you'll find some Banjo and Winnie the Pooh drawings. Probably some, like, ship fix too, but we'll just not go there. Oh, no! Okay, fine. So I can't go up the thing. I'll just... Oh my gosh, so many faces. I say that and now I'm thinking of the faces of evil. That terrible CDI Legend of Zelda game. I should livestream that. Okay, Mumbo's Mountain. Oh, okay, so it's a hub. That makes sense. So, wait, so her lair is a... Okay. Okay. So her lair is just like a place with... Yep, yes I have. It's not a jigsaw picture, it's a piece of a picture that's okay. Oh, we found the picture. Oh, God, okay. I understand things now. Oh my gosh, I can make the text go faster by holding the button. Yes. Jigsaw pieces, press B to leave. I like always do that in games. I read so fast in these things, and I was just... So, okay. Yeah. Oh, I kind of thought it'd, like, make me place it. Not that that would have been difficult right here, but... Mumbo's Mountain. Okay. Cool. Oh, but she can just talk to me? Oh! Oh, for a second I thought she was breaking the fourth wall and addressing my question, but, you know, I'm sorry, I just keep making references to games I've have played of this era, but I just want to jump into it. I'm pretty sure that Super Mario 64 was a launch title for the system, right? So that precedent was already set, but... Alright, mountain, cool. Oh man, a weird goblin thing. I don't like it. Three new moves to learn in... Oh no, that's not... No, I didn't want to go, I wanted to make... No, you're right, mole thing. I'm going back. I was trying to make the text go faster, and instead it just got me out of there. The cupcakes from Gravity Falls. Yeah. Oh, no, gosh. I know what you're talking about. Don't even... Koopa, no. Brenton, don't do it. It's bad. All right, find his mole hills. Die! Oh man, that was actually close. I feel like I didn't. Oh man, it's a thing. Oh, I got. Oh my gosh, how many things do I collect in this game? And there are music notes over there too. Oh, okay. Get a jiggy. Okay, sorry. I'll try and be a little more mature. Not that this game seems to call for an immense amount of maturity, but oh man, it's a... What? Oh my gosh. Okay. This game has to be the favorite of, like, collectors. People who have, like, collections of everything. Like, oh no, I pressed the wrong button. No, no! Stop bouncing over me, you stupid honeycomb thing. Alright, so I really want to know how to get the music notes over there, though. Oh, I guess I I keep forgetting I can double jump. I am not used to... I wonder if I can... Okay. I am not used to the... having the ability to double jump right out of the gate in games like this. But then I guess I did make a Jak and Daxter comparison a bit ago, and just mentioned that I just played Sly Cooper. Okay, I'm just apparently being stupid. Okay, music notes. 100? I don't even know if I even... No! Okay. Oh, how to just get up steep slopes? Okay. I'm all for that. Oh my gosh, giant ants. Okay, can I take these? No. I'm gonna slice up the plants. No, alright. I feel like the claw attack is kind of useless considering you have to stand still for it. I don't want to stand still and... I want to go and attack these guys. And yes, Aqua Sun. Something like that. I mean, I'm hardly a well-known Let's Player, considering this is the first time I've ever done it, so I don't expect a ton of viewers this time around. We'll see. Oh my gosh! Thank you. It's an old-timey camera. I'm giving it grace, but man. Oh no, I get the feeling I don't want to be around that thing. Oh, okay. I kind of thought when it said honeycomb, well, I guess the... No, the life things are like honeycombs. Ah! Oh no! Do I have to do the whole... Kazooie's thing? Ah, yeah! Suck it, bull thing. Why aren't you... Do I then need to... Oh, smart. No. No. No! Stop! Oh, crap. Get out of here, bull. Okay, well, I gotta... Oh, hey! It's another one of the... What are those things? I feel like not explaining these things is probably like part of the charm of the game, but the delay is about 30 seconds. Yeah, sorry, like I said, first time Let's Playing, I'm not quite used to... They're also on different screens because YouTube doesn't have particularly good comment setups on their streaming yet. Oh, I can't kill the wall. Why is the bowl there? Okay. Let's get these music notes. Though to be fair, I'm not much of a collector. I should probably just not waste time looking for them because I doubt I'm gonna get them all. But... makes sense. And yes, that's true, my name is Sam. I guess I had considered, you know, coming up with like a stage name for the show, but I couldn't figure anything out that worked. Yeah, I'm using XSplit. It's giving me about a 30 second delay. Oh, don't do that. That's mean. I like how the splatting orange is its own. Okay, that makes sense. I understand this. Like when you look at the orange hitting. Oh no, that's weird. It happened on the other one, but. Alright, cool. Oh! He hit his gold down there, only to be unlocked by throwing tangerines at it, and then threw... or oranges, or whatever, and then threw them down there. That's... okay. It's not a very smart monkey thing. Alright, cool. Turn to the start. That makes sense, yeah. Oh yeah, and I already figured that out because I was trying to make the text go faster. So. Oh, he's still throwing oranges. Well, I guess I did steal his gold piece. Oh, hello, Diddy Kong. Okay. I mean, there are a bunch of oranges around, but I feel like if I get hit with them, I'm probably gonna lose lives. So I'll go up here and of course I can do nothing. Okay. Oh, I got one. How did I get one? Oh, I didn't actually see it in the tree. That's okay. Okay, cool. There's your orange. Oh, my poor Banjo's getting called fat, though I guess he doesn't really seem to care. Silent protagonist. I feel like I'm once again in a situation where I could talk about, like, the narrative. Oh, no. The narrative delivery, but that this game probably also just doesn't. Oh my gosh, how many things do I collect in this game? This is crazy. I guess I can't really do anything with these yet. I'm going to assume there's not really anything I can do on this, I guess. I don't know. Alright, well. I'll come back. Oh no, I didn't mean to do that, but okay. At least I didn't get hurt. Oh, there's a molehill thing. Maybe he needs to teach me that other move or something. Really? Yeah, I didn't have a 64 when all these games were coming out, so I didn't get to play Donkey Kong 64 either, and, yeah. See, to shoot. Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah, that was my thought. Kazooie. Alright. Though to be fair, Kazooie's kind of a jerk sometimes, so I don't feel... That's just gonna be a major theme, I guess. Kazooie complaining about things and me not feeling any sympathy. Egg sighting. Okay. What a punny mole. Oh, hey, it just gave me a ton of them. That's cool. Oh, thank you. I like this mole. This mole is my favorite character. Oh. That's what it takes, right? Okay, yeah. No! That timing! I am sure I can do it, though. Please. Please someone tell me if I, not... Oh, jump and Z is ground pound. That's good to know. If I just can't attack that guy, someone please let me know before I kill myself. I'll ground pound on this thing first, so there's time for the stream to catch up. Yeah. I guess I can't do it until I've learned it, huh? Alright. Oh, well. Okay. And yes, indeed, that pun was excellent. Just puns. Oh no! Okay, well. Oh, oh, that is so obvious in hindsight. man, alright. So let's see. Really? Of course she is. What? Because didn't I have to... I thought I had to go into first person to do it. Maybe I misunderstood him. I'll go back and ask him, since the stupid stream means I can't ask you guys because it's behind. Oh, hold. Okay. Oh, that makes sense. Okay, I'd interpreted that as going into first person and then, okay. Oh, no! Ow! Okay, I will admit, I did not expect him to retaliate. Nope, not what I meant. Do it. Oh, I can, like, rapid fire. That's neat. Okay. How do I shut egg, indeed? Yeah. Oh. You gotta love that logic. I'm like, oh man, the bear came over here and stole my stuff and then shot a bunch of eggs at me. But, you know, instead of just feeling violated and assaulted or something, I'm just gonna give him stuff. That's... Was that a gulping sound? Is he- Ow! You jerk! You just gave me stuff! Yeah, you are a good shot. Now get- Well, to be fair, I guess he rewards brutality toward him, so why not- Nope. Okay. Can- Okay. Alright, bowl, no- No! Just back where I came from, so I guess I'll just climb up there again. Nope, bad bolt. Do not want! No! Okay, good. If he could have followed me up there, I would have been very screwed. And yes, indeed, the character development on that 8, I feel like I could do like a... You know, psychiatric analysis of him or something. I'm sure there's something to be said about, like, Stockholm Syndrome or something, I don't know. That'll be a future episode of Games is Lit, the way that the random ape dude from the first level of Banjo and Kazooie mirrors abusive relationships or something. That'll be a dark episode. Oh man, another... Ew, yeah. And Man, I feel like... Like, what was it? I think it was Game Theory that did that episode saying that Mario would totally be guilty of, like, a million war crimes. I think that's even more true of this dude. Like... I'm just, oh, I need health. Let's destroy the home of these bees. I'll just pelt this guy with eggs until it gives me something I need. Yeah. Oh, well, I knew that wasn't the type of jump that would get me far, but still. Oh, more things over that way. Okay. Everything is alive in this world. Loose stones. Okay, I guess I'll attend to that later, unless those skull things I've been finding are what they're talking about. Oh no. Let me position myself better. Yeah! Okay. I take it I'll need a decent amount of puzzle pieces for the next bit, because... No. Yes! Haha! I knew I could do it. Now I'll do nothing up here, because there's nothing to do. Alright. Let's see what happens in there. Oh, eggs! Maybe. Oh, okay. It's telling me about the... I'll try the eggs when I get back out of here. Oh, he was in the funny opening thing. Okay. Filthy feathered one. Poor Kazooie, kind of. Okay. Oh, so it's Mumbo's tokens and the witch took the... Okay. Five. Okay. That's fine. I didn't come in here looking for business. I didn't even know what you did or that you were in here. So I'll see you in a bit, dude. And until then, yeah, thing I got it. So yeah, I'll try, I guess, shooting eggs. I guess that would make sense. It like it's a timing thing. And I forgot what button I was pushing, so I failed the timing thing. Yes! Haha! Wonderful! Aquasyn, you are my hero. Oh no, it gets fast. Yeah. Okay. Yes! I am indeed the master of shooting eggs into random spinny totem pole things. Go me. Alright. Seriously, is Kazooie eating them? That gulping sound effect makes me think he's eating the puzzle pieces, and that just doesn't seem healthy or like it's going to help us. Though, I mean, to be fair, it's clear at this point that applying logic into this game is really more for humor than actual insight. Hey. Well. Then I'll just start killing everyone in here, I guess. These implications, guys. These implications. Oh no. Okay, well, I guess I need to learn how to climb on steep things first. Oh, stupid mole hasn't been anywhere around to teach me these things. He's only used his telepathy or something. Music notes. There are 100 of these in each one? Sheesh. Okay. I will get all of them. On this weird Stonehenge thing. Oh, hey, an orange alien dude. Oh, Mars. The first note door? Okay. I don't think I've encountered that, have I? Am I just forgetting it? Every time Banjo opens his mouth, actually reminds me a little bit of Goofy. Oh, hey, molehill thing. Teach me, oh wise, holy bigger person. Yes, wonderful. Okay. I'm still kind of impressed, I guess, that, Kazooie's a girl, apparently. Yeah, yeah. Okay, left C button. Oh. Nope. Oh, okay. I guess I'm... Oh, right. So I need to... Oh, okay. I find this amusing. I'm just gonna go through the whole game like this. This is great. Nah. Okay. It does make controlling the camera kind of a pain on some of the buttons, but... Alright, and... Oh, another... No. You don't slide, you're the one who's letting me control it. Another weird alien thing! Okay, so apparently some hills are even too steep. These things... I just... This is great. I don't know, I find this animation super funny. I mean, look at Banjo, too. He's like... I don't know, he looks kind of crestfallen, actually. He's like, aww. But I'm just keeping with this, because this is hilarious. Alright, I feel like I've explored everywhere I've found so far. Oh, except further in here. Right, because I need to... Okay. Oh, hey, I actually, This is too much fun. Can I jump like this? Yes, I can. Can I double jump? No. Okay. Still worth it.
Wow.
Oh, no. I need the thing. No! What? Well, how am I supposed to do that? Nope! Oh, man, but I need to get, like, all the way around or something, it looks like. I mean, I can't adjust the camera in this place, really, but... Okay. That is true. I should find things and play the game. Though, that said, I don't necessarily mind some hints on occasion, because searching around for ages trying desperately to find the right answer is no fun. Like, right about now, do I need something else to get up there? Like, I guess I probably do. I'll go out and search for something else, and if all this, Oh, hey, I'm not the only one in this stream who hasn't played the game before. That's actually kind of nice, because I'm very lost. All right. Man, I feel like I should have a group of people giving me hints and telling me what to do when I play, like, some classic horror games. Like, man, that would have made Silent Hill 2 a lot easier. None of those obtuse, you know, drop the bag of flour into the garbage chute puzzles.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Yes. Alright. I don't know why, that this animation will never get old. This is hilarious. Alright, so. Oh, hey. Yes. Okay. I'm done for now. That's funny. Games is lit advisors. Beak Buster. Okay. Man, there are a lot of different things. Okay. I do. Man. Oh, yeah. It's like they specifically made it so Kazooie was kind of funny, but kind of mean, and you wouldn't necessarily like her, and so they're just like, let's just make it so all the moves in the gameplay are punishing her horribly. Alright, okay, now that I know that, I do know where I need to go now, because... I remember... Oh, and it's over there, okay. Oh no! No! Okay. Maybe there's more stuff I missed, like fish. Fish. Oh man, 2D sprite fish. They're very rare. I'm very lucky to have found some. Though I get the feeling they'll be all over in this game, so maybe it's just a... I don't know. Nope! I will run faster! Yes! Oh man, okay. Yeah. Fine. Oh my gosh. I keep expecting things to be like just a little bit more responsive than they are when it comes to that jump. But is it just me or does Banjo sound kinda like Mickey Mouse when he jumps? Alright. Yeah, Yeah, this whole streaming thing is proving to be unique. I honestly don't even watch much in the way of live streams personally, but oh, I hope I can climb that. I actually just earlier today watched the game show episode. And hopefully some of you are familiar with that. It's basically the idea channel of video games put on by PBS and everything. I finally got around to watching through their archives. I haven't gotten too far, but I watched the episode today about Let's Plays, where he theorized that Let's Plays have gotten as popular as they are because it kind of makes gaming a community experience again, you know, like before when everyone would gather around that one kid who could afford the Nintendo console and stuff, or arcades for that matter, that it was all a community thing, and that live streams kind of make it so that's, or even just Let's Plays. Oh, okay. Oh, nope, that's not what I meant to do. So yeah, just said, I don't know, I find that interesting. So come on. No, what, really? Did he explain how to get up there and I was too busy saying things and not being good at talking as well as I do this? Oh, okay, that's... there's something else I need to get in there? I wanted to go up there and get that jigsaw puzzle, but, I don't know how. The whole... this isn't working. Maybe I need to... okay, some high-level moves here. And then bring up... yes, no! Oh, well, that wasn't even what I meant to do, but since I'm in here, so, what else was I supposed to do in here? Oh, the notes? No, I don't know, are the notes super important? Like, you know, they seem to me at the moment kind of like the feathers in Assassin's Creed 2 or something, like, I don't necessarily want to get them all. No, I'll go back and get them if I end up wanting to later, I guess. Then I find out I'm gonna miss out on a true ending or something for it. It's... yeah. No! I seriously do not know how to get this. I'm so confused. Ant! That ant at least looked angry after- oh my gosh. I dismembered it. Horribly. How? I can't progress in the game without... if I don't get the notes? That kind of surprises me. I wouldn't think the game would require me to get all the notes for progression. That's kind of... can someone just tell me how to get up this mountain? Yeah, I could see how Let's Plays could offer a very different experience for people based on who's playing. It's like he has his footing there for a second and then just doesn't, like a cartoon character got flung over a cliff and takes a second to fall. But yeah, stories out of the game, especially in a game like Minecraft, I can see how it'd be fun to watch people kind of just do their own thing and have a story that they make out of it. Well, but it's a piece. Okay, I guess I'll see, Oh, man. Okay, so every time I go somewhere, I guess I'm gonna go over here and see if there's... Oh, right, because I can go out here now, so maybe later on I'll get something that lets me get the puzzle piece up there. Assuming I have enough puzzle pieces for the next world, I guess. Oh, and 50 music notes. Oh, so I need one. No, they're gonna go away, Mole. I guess I have full health, so I shouldn't care too much. But still, they're gonna blink out of existence while you talk to me. Powerful musical spells. Okay. I don't think I have 50 yet. No. Okay, yeah, I was kind of thinking that I had to... Oh, hey, they're still here. I was kind of thinking that I would have to... You know, like, if that was the last puzzle piece and I needed to get it before moving on or something. I guess not, but... I don't think I... Oh, 86. No, I'm good. Yeah, go me. I walked up to a door. It was great. See, that makes more sense, requiring that you do a bit of the extra stuff to move on, but not all of it. I've seen that in a good few games before, and I'm trying to think of which. For some odd reason, the only one coming to mind is the Prince of Persia reboot in 2008 with Nolan North. But, did she just say that door was easy to got past? Man. No one in this game says, oh my gosh, a ghost. Is that an axe? Oh, a wand. Okay, okay. Yeah. Wow, that's quite a let's play from Crusader Kings 2. Alright, so... Oh, that... Okay. Hi, Glenda. Wow. Some sisterly feuds, I guess, man. Yeah, I'm her sister. Beat up the old hag. Nah. Okay. I'm already bad at remembering things in this game, but... Okay. Well... Did she say to press B if I want to actually... Tuna ice cream flavored toothpaste? That sounds... No, not... My wife is weird, guys. Aw, man, it's a thing. Die thing. Why do I feel like a worse human being playing this than I do playing... Spec Ops. Yeah, Spec Ops. No, it's not quite that bad. I completely missed what he said because my wife referenced an amazing video game. Dang it. Okay, well, I'm sure you guys will tell me once I get there, so... Oh gosh, yeah, the horror story secret of Animal Crossing is great. I found that a long time ago, and that was excellent. I mean, it was disturbing as heck, but so funny. It just made so much sense. Something to put down. Oh, so I can remove... Oh! I guess it's probably going to give me access to multiple worlds at a time. And then, I need to, like, choose which ones I put on, I suppose? That's interesting. Alright, so pirate-themed level next, huh? Oh, hey, Pixel Head! Oh, okay, bye, Koopa. No, I guess that's Roy, yeah. For those not aware, he's in the credits of all of them, but Pixel Head is the one who wrote the theme song for Games as Lit 101, so say hi to him, and thanks for, you know, doing cool things and making cool musics. I'm missing the... Oh, there's another painting up there. Okay, cool. No? Walking up a ramp isn't really any less exercise than walking up stairs, but... Man. not very good at what she does, is she? Alright, so I guess right now, unless someone decides to tell me, I guess unless someone decides to tell me what I missed over here, because I don't know what I'm supposed to do. The claw. Oh, no, wait. The claw makes me think I need to. No. Do that. No. Okay. And I already tried that. That didn't work. Smashing the bird's head into it. I guess I'll just go up here. I don't know where the. Like, that opened a world somewhere, but I don't know where, so I guess I'll just move on until I find it. Okay, oh, I haven't actually done videos directly about Telltale yet. You can bet, I'm probably gonna do a literary analysis of the first season of The Walking Dead at some point. Just cause, amazing. And I might for The Wolf Among Us too. I didn't like it quite as much as The Walking Dead, but it was excellent. And then of course the very last scene, like the whole. I don't want to give spoilers for the others in here, but man, the whole speech at the end, like I was getting convinced. You know, that was some of the best writing I've ever seen. So yeah, no, I will do some Telltale stuff. I've certainly mentioned them and talked about them plenty. They're doing a Marvel game? Oh my gosh, yes. Okay. Yeah, I actually tweeted just a little while ago that it'd be the greatest thing if they did a game based on Modica Magica. I don't know if anyone in this stream has seen that, but it'll never happen. At least I don't expect it, so, because Telltale, I don't know, I'd love for them to do some anime stuff, but. Oh, well, that's kind of your problem, then. Man, she's sort of like, oh, I'm ugly. I don't like being ugly. And then she just goes, hey, I'd never take a bath. That's. I feel like she's kind of responsible for all her problems. Yes, very much like Sokka. No, no! What did I do? No camera! Okay. Where am I? Oh, okay. I guess I have to. Eggs! Man, it's fun seeing, like, I don't know, the textures and, rather the lines are pretty clear cut and such, but then a lot of the icons are very clearly pixel art. Oh my gosh, there are apparently going to be a lot of puzzle pieces in this game, because, man, alright. I assume, though, these are all organized by difficulty to some extent, but. Yeah, basically. I mean, kind of, Aquasun, it's, Modica Magica is, for, at the risk of using an incredibly overused word for it, essentially a deconstruction of, oh, hey, cool, life. A deconstruction of magical girl things. It starts off kind of like it, and then goes, no, actually, this is kind of horrifying, and, gets, you know, really dark and intense and really amazing. And then at the end just kind of also reconstructs what a magical girl is supposed to be. And, you know, it's pretty amazing. And it has a lot of, like, some choices that the characters would have to make would be perfect for Telltale's style. Okay, how do I get back up? Oh, no, can I climb on these? Yes! Haha! No! This is a complex hub area. So, alright, I'll head back here and see if maybe I missed a pipe that I can climb up. I did! I think. There's. Nope, it's just in the background. Okay. And I still don't know where that is. Okay, maybe I'll just. I don't think I have enough puzzle pieces to open any of the other ones I've found, but. Is it back there? Laughing. Okay, I guess I'll just move on. Like, I feel like I'm probably just gonna get lost or something. I don't know, but I haven't found where else to go, so. Oh, hey! Man, it's all the way over here? Well, time to do a weird flippy jump into this treasure chest. Alright, cool. I like how it looks like it loads it and then brings that up. Must be a treasure trove cove, okay. Wait, he's talking like a pirate now? Oh no! No! Ah! Yeah, I know there's one new move. At least, weren't it? Yeah, Aquasun, I can recommend few anime more highly than Monica Magica. It's an excellent one. Okay. I'm glad he's giving me this whole thing to go. Oh man, there's a thing down there. Oh no. Should I be- Oh no! 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 At freaking sharks. Oh, and then it just disappears? That's mean. I guess it's only really there to keep me out there, like that stupid big fish in, like that stupid big fish in, No! Like that giant fish in, Jack and Daxter. It scared the crap out of me when I was a kid and played that. I'm just like, oh man, I wonder what happens if I swim and then it just gobbles me. Ugh. Oh, nope. Okay. Well, lots of places to go. I guess I'll go this way toward the... You know what? He looks cute with all the googly eyes. I'm gonna hope he's a good guy. No! Even though I just murdered one of his kin, I guess. I don't... Yeah, Jack and Daxter. Oh, have you not heard of that? Yeah, it's a Naughty Dog PS2 era. Yeah. It's good. Well, Jack and Daxter's excellent. Jack 2 is amazing. Nothing, huh? Kazooie is consistently failing her charisma checks here. She needs to put a few points into persuasion. Ah! Man! We could have gotten the thing's help, you stupid bird. Oh, okay, yeah. Yeah, I am aware of the website. We haven't been using it as much because we haven't had time to actually work on what it was meant to be doing. No. And yay for playing Jack and Daxter. It's an excellent series to catch up on. Oh man, oh no. Fine, so. Let's see. No, not that. This. Oh, I keep forgetting I need to hold down the button. I just passed my best note score for this world. Man, go me. Oh yeah, oh okay, so the notes actually, like, return each time? That's interesting. I mean, it seems like that'd make it a little too easy to gather notes. You just come in and grab a few notes and then get out of there. But, I don't know, maybe they don't count it until you pass the score. Oh, I was gonna attack him and then I saw he was crying and was like, well, that would be mean. And yeah, I actually just started playing Sly Cooper myself. I tried a little bit back on the PS2, but I got the collection on Vita and just finished the first one. So that'll be fun to get to as I continue through. An old sea hippo, huh? It's probably the only context in which... Oh, I forgot the banjo talk. Okay. I was thinking of him as a silent protagonist. What? No. Yes. Haha. It's kind of hard to aim that. Okay. It's also fun to see what these developers moved on to. You know, like, we're... Like, Naughty Dog, of course, moving on to Uncharted and, The Last of Us, of all things, which, of course, is an incredible game. And then, yes, Sly Cooper is, That wasn't Insomniac. Insomniac is, it was Sucker Punch, right? Sly Cooper was, and so they're doing Infamous now. Yeah. No. There you go. Stupid. Alright. Okay. Yeah, you know, I've noticed that with a lot of video game trilogies for some reason. Like the first one's interesting, the second one builds on it and perfects it, the third one kind of adds some stuff but isn't quite as good ultimately. This was kind of similar with Assassin's Creed, though Black Flag is my favorite of that series. Just want to maybe once you get past 3, it gets more complicated. Aw, poor bitch. What a lazy bear. Turkey. Man, these two just really got off to a bad start. Jump disc. Oh! Okay. Aw. See, I like this mole. This mole is best character. For certain. What? But no. Okay, I must have missed something in that explanation. I'm still just not used to talking while I play the game. It's really weird. Shock jump, yes. Oh, so just stand on it and press it. Oh, I get it. Okay. Okay. Okay, I get it. That makes sense. Yeah, Infamous is a favorite of mine for certain. Oh no! First one was pretty good, but the second one was incredible. It's one of my favorite superhero, like, things ever. Second Son wasn't quite as good as the second one, but I really liked it. Yeah. Okay. I imagine there is stuff that I should be finding over here by doing these jumpy plates, so... Oh no, ah! Man, I always think I'm gonna overshoot it if I hold the button, but then I end up coming up short because I let go instead of just continuing, to move forward. Now, I'm gonna get these musical notes while I'm over here. No, no! Okay. Let's see. So, getting on this thing. The game doesn't seem to be too difficult of one, but I get the feeling I might end up being a little frustrated just because I'm not going to be that good at it, but we'll see. Admittedly, I am, you know, I care a lot about video games, but more because of the experience than challenge, so it's like, oh my gosh, what? This is an evil monster. Is that a mimic? Like from RPGs where you find the chest and then it's just no. Nope. Bad crab. Okay. Oh no. I'm gonna fall off getting these. I just know I will. Alright. Oh! Feathers! What are feathers? Well, I mean, I know what feathers are, but what? No! Oh, come on! Freaking... Okay. One more time, and then I'm moving on to other things in this world. So then, am I eventually gonna need to get every puzzle piece in this game, I guess? Or, just... I mean, I guess it would make the most sense that the... Oh, hey. That the music notes are, Oh, I'll have to learn to fly. Okay. I guess it would make the most sense that, I'd have to get all the puzzle pieces and some of the notes. Oh. I like the way these things talk. That's nice. Oh, hey, and anyone in the chat... Can anyone in the chat confirm the, volume ratio of voice to game. No one's complained about it yet, so I guess it's probably not bad. I was messing with that, but I don't necessarily know how it sounds for streamers. I found that the default for XSplit, my voice was way too quiet to hear. So I had to turn the game down a lot, but... Alright, what's with these? Can I safely attack it? Nah. Right, so I just don't want to jump in it, I guess? That seems like kind of a crappy enemy where the only... Okay, cool, thanks, Aquason. It seems like a crappy enemy where the only way for me to die is to purposefully jump into it. So, I don't know. The teeth do not make it look friendly. So... Oh. Oh, but... Oh, okay. I don't know what happened. I was holding on, but... Alright, and that's a... mine? Man, who builds something that's made specifically for the purpose of exploding and then gives it sapience, or sentience at least? Like, it's got eyes. That thing's alive, and its only purpose is to die a fiery death. It's like Voltorb. It makes me sad. Down there, probably. Maybe, I don't know. There are enough feathers around, I might just get them. Unless, of course, it's another collector thing and I need a bunch of feathers to do stuff. Because, I mean, that's a mine. I don't want to... I'll get them if I have to. I don't want to risk blowing it up. And also blowing myself up with it. Oh? I'll jump in it and time it right. I guess that would make sense. Except that the teeth still make me think that jumping into its gaping maw would not be the greatest idea. But, I don't know. Like, as a challenge, it would make sense. The timing... You know what? Why not? I'll try it. I mean, I've got enough banjo lives and enough banjo health, so... This is horrifying. I don't know if I want to do this. Oh, a little too early. Okay. Oh. Well, man, Aquason, for someone who's never played the game, you're being very... his nose. I'm getting a kick out of that. Oh no, and I hit the teeth on the way out. That's annoying. Anyway, you're being very helpful for someone who hasn't actually played the game before. That's awesome. Alright, Alright, that's where I started. There's some stuff to do over there, and then... Oh, I can probably hit this guy with eggs. I don't know why I didn't think of that. Oh, and now I can use that thing to get back up. That's nice. I'm always a fan of, you know, kind of Metroidvania style. Hey, no, I didn't do that. Mine. No! Like, that comes with, like, a little fart sound effect. How am I... I'm just gonna come back and assume that I need to learn something to take him on, I guess. And yeah, just eggs. Giant enemy crab, indeed. When I do have to finally take that on, I'll have to remember to talk about a crab battle the entire time. And that'd be an interesting series to stream, Metal Gear Solid. But I've already played those, so... Okay, so what was the point of this? Like... Okay, cool. That's what I figured. Oh my gosh, another alien thingy up there. I will save it. No! It moves toward me? I guess that explains why they made it sentient. But still, that's horrifying. Based on real Japanese history. Wait, are you talking about the giant enemy crab or Metal Gear Solid? Because I hadn't been aware of Metal Gear Solid being based on something. It's a little too, you know, completely insane. Yeah, I know, right? It's... I don't know what crabs ever did to video game developers, but... I'm gonna hope this thing can't go underwater. Oh, hey! Yes! But yeah, you know, I do really like this, yeah. This was the... That tendency with the music to be a little different. I don't know what started that. Like, I know it's in, Mario Galaxy and Mario, and Super Mario Sunshine. Crab Spirit. Wow. Super Mario Sunshine as well as, ow! Fine. Mario Sunshine as well as Galaxy. I forget if it was in 64 or not. But I really like that, you know, like the music's playing and when you're underwater it plays a little differently because you're underwater. Oh my gosh, I hate old-timey camera controls. I forget how my health is. I'll just destroy it in case. Oh, okay, good. I don't need that one though, so I'm not gonna risk falling off. Just man, I would love to be able to more easily see this from a side perspective. Okay, there we are. Oh, well, this pop-in's crazy. I just see a box. I'm like, well, nothing to see there, and then I get close enough. Oh, no. The shark's gonna be around, isn't it? No! No! No, you don't. Get out of here, shark. Wow, a teleporting shark. Okay. Okay, cool. Also, I like how his speech sounds are bites. Like a... just, yeah. Nope. Nope. I don't like you. Bad shark. Okay, I have been over there, yes. So I need to focus more on being over here. Okay, man, if that thing just floated wrong so I couldn't get on it, I would have been upset. Alright. So I guess this is what's gonna make the most sense. No. Bad shark. Get out of here. Oh man, why is there a life down there? Here, get a life so you can lose it when the shark catches up with you. Jerks. Swimming in shark. Oh, that makes... oh man. Alright. Alright, those things. I don't like them. Let's see, what's in these guys? Flowers, feathers. Sorry, not flowers, feathers. And music notes. Well, I'll need some of those. Ah, no! Hey, music notes. Oh, I hadn't even noticed the shark's eyebrows. I guess I'll have to take a look at that. Yeah, okay. So, okay, yeah, the shark is apparently some kind of, like, weird... like, it's just... the ocean is the shark, and it materializes into a shark when it wants to eat things, I guess? It's starting to sound like a Doctor Who villain or something. Oh my gosh, FLCL. You know, I haven't seen that since I first watched it a long time ago, but my wife and I... heck, we went in on the Blu-ray collection before, you know, while we were still dating... intending to watch it and try and figure out what the heck it is. It's such a confusing, weird anime. Oh man, an X. FLCL is short for Fooly Cooly, I guess, or something. I don't know. But I don't know. When I think anime eyebrow characters, I think of Gai Sensei from Naruto. Like, I think Naruto even calls him, like, bushy brows or something, though. No? OK, Okay, so this is, gonna try this. Oh, hey, yes. Oh, clues, okay. Oh, for a second I kind of thought he was gonna say, follow the clues if you're looking for a good time, and I was gonna be kind of scared. Oh my gosh, FLCL would make a really interesting action RPG. See, I'm getting a bit better at, you know, following the chat down here. It's made easier by having a computer that actually updates it automatically, but still, I just need to remember to look down there. Yeah, coming of age story I've got. I did read up on it when I watched it, because otherwise it was like the most confusing thing ever. But I just, you know, it's been so long that I don't remember it super well. But I know that, like, everything means something, so I really wanna... Oh! Shark eyebrows. Ah, dang it, too late. Really, shark? You're really gonna make me... No! Oh my gosh, you're right. I guess that's the only way to make him look angry. Like... I feel like without the eyebrows, he would just look like a normal shark that isn't trying to kill you. Strongest eyebrow. Oh my gosh, I forgot about that. I don't think I ever... Bad clam. I don't like you. Get out of here. And there's a random crab on that island. Okay. I see no reason. Oh no, there's probably some other important thing over there that's just not fading into the game. Yeah! Well, this random little island is completely pointless. Yes. Oh man, like an underwater castle thing. I'm over. Ah, stupid bomb. Oh, and the bomb is right over the music notes. That's just not even cool. What is it that's out here? Oh no! 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 You don't appear right in front of me. That's not how you work, shark. I don't like you. Shark appears behind me, not in front of me. That's stupid. Alright, let's see what's in here. I feel like that sound effect is the same for like everything. Oh, shoot the bomb with an egg. That is smart. I will try that when I get back up. Oh no. I'm gonna do like a word puzzle or something. Banjo-Kazooie. Oh, okay. So. Okay. Either the creators of the... Oh, I get it! But it's full of water. Do I need to, like... Nope, not what I meant. Like, if I had to jump, that would make sense. B, A... There's not really an N. No, I'm thinking, like, I'd jump on it, you know, jump on each letter, and that would open the gate or something, except that... Except that it doesn't seem like, you know, it's filled with water, so I can't actually jump on it. I'm a little confused, but alright, I'll try this later. There definitely is some old-timey game design sensibilities, you know? We like holding the player's hand now, which... You know, I don't completely like or dislike, honestly. Like, I... Oh, right. Try to shoot it. Like, I can understand why it's kind of annoying to have a game just hold your hand the entire time instead of letting you figure stuff out for yourself, but... Okay, am I right in thinking that was... good hit, or it should have been. Just, yeah, like, I understand why it's nice for a game to kind of trust you to come up with stuff on your own, but come on. actually bomb. Cool. Sorry, I keep getting distracted by the actual game and not finishing my thoughts. I would imagine that I might be able to drain it somehow, but I'm not seeing how yet. Anyway, yeah, like, I could see why it's annoying to have a game hold your hand, but at the same time, stop that. No, not what I meant. At the same time, I also really appreciate- Oh, I can! Yes! Haha! You are being such help. Yeah, at the same time, you know, personally, I am also one who really likes to, experience a game, and I don't necessarily want, you know, getting lost or dying a lot to get in the way of that. I can think of a good few games where that just kind of ruin the atmosphere, and heck, it's worse than horror games. Like, I love Silent Hill 2, like, it's freaking amazing, but it definitely, like, there was a point where it didn't feel scary anymore sometimes because, you know, I'd just be running around trying to find some stupid thing for a puzzle or something. So, I'm a fan of hand-holding in some contexts, but it's... In any case, I'm just not used to it, I guess. It's been a while. Alright, so I am missing a molehill. Something awful, I think. Oh, and also that dude. I forget what he wanted from me. Dark Souls, yeah. Oh, gosh. I actually haven't played Dark Souls yet because I want to finish Demon's Souls. Like, I love Demon's Souls. It's, I don't know, it's just such exquisite game design. You know, it's tough, but it's tough because it's fair and harsh, not because it's just stupid and cheap, you know? Oh, there's a thing. Boom. So yeah, I love it, but it's so hard that it takes so much time, you know? I do eventually get kind of frustrated when I've spent, you know, 10 hours playing the game and barely actually done anything. Alright, well. Good. If the shark showed up in here too, I was going to get very angry. I did not actually mean to go over there, but... Alright, incom tokam indeed. I concur, Skull. Aw, man, Goldberg- Oh my gosh, how many things? Oh, his tri- okay. I was like, man, am I collecting gold bars now, too? What is this? And yeah, tough but fair, that's the way to... Yeah, you know, the combat in Silent Hill can do that, but it also... I don't know, it's clunky, but it's really kind of made to be, you know, like... I'm not sure the game would have worked as well if it had, like, fast, fluid combat of some kind. It's very... Yeah, I don't know. I get that. I don't think it's, you know, like, I talked in that... yeah, I know. Everything alive, right? I talked in the last episode of the show, actually, about horror games. Oh, right. About, you know, horror games that use their mechanics to the advantage of the fear and the horror and stuff. And, oh, here. And I don't think Silent Hill does that. It makes the mechanics fit fine, you know, there's no dissonance between the narrative and the gameplay, which is good, of course, but at the same time, it's very, the interaction itself is fairly simple, so there's nothing like, you know, the camera being symbolic in Outlast or anything like that. Okay, I feel like I'm missing something in there. I'm gonna talk to him and see. No, don't punch him. Talk. Okay, fine. I'll just swim around in here a little more and see, like, I would think that I could maybe get through some of those doors or something, but I'm pretty sure that'd be just outside the ship. And I don't see an entrance on the other side. Oh, well, that's helpful. Oh, okay. I see it down there. So... okay, see, it's stuff that I like about... oh, no! This kind of thing is the thing I do like about games not holding your hands. Because, like, now I get to... like, discover the entrance and be all like, oh, that's how I get there. Except that it doesn't seem to actually help much. Maybe it's the other side. And, yeah, the Shattered Memories, I... don't remember getting, like, insanely good reviews or anything, but I remember hearing some good stuff on that front. Oh, there it is. Man, how didn't I notice that before? And if I remember, that was the one that was supposed to be, like, a... well, yeah, and see, that's the thing, is that's when Silent Hill was at its best, when it was, reflected, because that's what makes Silent Hill 2 so brilliant, is it's all, reflective of the psyche of the main character. That's where... I still haven't played through the whole series, but I've heard that, the games eventually forgot that Silent Hill, the town, was supposed to be a reflection of the character's psyche, not, you know, an actual literal town with a history and stuff. I know the movie did. Like, honestly, the Silent Hill movie was interesting, because the whole first half I was like, yes, perfect, you nailed the atmosphere, you know, I mean, it's a different story and all that, and I'm kind of sick and tired of that, but still, the atmosphere was great, the visuals were great, Pyramid Head looked fantastic, and then the last half it started being all like, and this is the crazy thing that happened that made Silent Hill so horrible, and I just really don't like that for the series. It's... I'm trying to come up with a similar example from, like, a movie or something where everything is a mindscape, and then it just goes, nope, it's real. It's kind of annoying. Oh, really? Like, actual tests? They had actual tests in the game? Because, I mean, Silent Hill 1 and 2 both were more like the actions you took in the game were your psyche test. Like, you know, you'd... in the second... I forget if you could in the first game. In the second game, you could get an ending where your character just commits suicide. And a lot of that would be based on, like, if you're running around with low health a lot of the time, or, or something like that. Like... it would just, depending on how you played, it would do that, which was really cool. Yeah. Off to... yeah, you go off to spend. Yeah, puzzle piece. Okay, so I guess I just need to go around and get enough puzzle pieces to go to each of these areas and move further, so yeah. How you fought and if you fought. Yeah, that too, how, like, if you stomped stuff and killed it when it was already down or something, it would be a worse ending, right? I'd forgotten about that, actually. Yeah, I just... really interesting. You don't see many games with that kind of embedded choice these days, you know? Like, Metro 2033 did it. Well, to be fair, that's not a these days thing. But very few games have done that in general. Metro 2033 had a weird, like... you wouldn't even know it existed without... oh, hey, I can learn flight. You wouldn't even know it existed just playing the game, really. Its morality system was interesting like that. And then, weirdly enough, Black Ops 2. Like, not a morality thing, but, you know, just... like, there was a mission I remember where I was surprised to, like, oh, I didn't catch the guy. And then at the end, I found out that I could have caught him. And I'm like, whoa... I don't know, that's more than I expect from Call of Duty. Bogus. Calm down, Kazooie. Man. Just... these two characters remind me of the middle schoolers at the school I do the after-school program with. Yeah, I work in an after-school program, and man, they're always doing that, you know? Like, just... one of them insults the other, and then they just continue insulting each other over and over, and then getting mad, you know, like, oh, it's their fault, and it's kind of both. You know. I want to make these two sit on opposite ends of the room. Okay, is someone whistling at me, or is that in the music? Music, I assume. Okay. Cool. Okay, well. So, let's see. No. Hey, no. No! Crap. No. Bad shark. Oh, no. Okay. What was I gonna say? Oh, the flight. It seemed like the flight wasn't inverted. Like, what doesn't have inverted flight? I'm one of those weird people that likes playing everything inverted. You know, I like my cameras to be inverted and all that stuff, but regardless, flight is always inverted. That's just a thing. Okay, let's try this again and see if I'm just wrong. I would love to be wrong. Whoosh. Okay, now it is. Oof, nope. Nope. I'm gonna fall off. Okay. The movement is a little slippery, not like Super Mario where they're slippery, but slippery enough that I'm concerned. Even for flight, like everything's in flight. It's like a joystick, you know, you pull back to move up and for just... I do that for cameras too, just because I've done a lot of cinematography work. I was majoring in a film production for a while, so it still kind of makes sense to me, you know. It's I'm controlling a camera, not just telling it where to move. No. Ah. I hate these things. There you go. Die, you stupid clam. Except in flight, okay. Yeah, it comes down to personal preference. There's obviously not anything that, you know, I've gotten into arguments just for fun about whether inverted or non-inverted controls make sense, but, you know, it's just for make more sense. But that's just for fun, you know. Ultimately, it kind of just comes down to whatever floats your boat, but... It just always made a little more sense to me to have it inverted. Oh, there was a hole there, and I didn't see it because the camera! Nah! Okay. There's that thing. Oh! There's stuff under it. Okay. I will help you, little weird alien thing. Yeah, that was the... Oh, hey, Andrew. I know this person. Oh, I got a puzzle piece for it. That's cool. And yeah, basically, that's a good way of saying it. And, you know, it's similar. Otherwise, inverted makes most sense to me, and so when it's not inverted. It does make it difficult. Like, sometimes I'll play through a video game with someone else. Even just a single-player game, you know, I've done it with my cousin a lot and my wife a few times, and it always gets, you know, when we hand over the controller to one another, we gotta change the controls between inverted and not. It's a bit of a pain, but, you know, I seriously, like, cannot even play otherwise, so, no. Oh, no! Nah. Andrew, the person who just joined, was actually in my... before, I recently moved, so I'm not doing it right now, but I, at one point was lucky enough to find a school who allowed me to teach, two schools actually, who allowed me to teach video games as literature to, some high schoolers, and Andrew was in one of those classes, so that's neat. I'm hoping to do that again at some point, because, man, it was fun, actually, teaching this stuff, you know? I mean, still had a couple kids who, like, didn't do their homework, even when it was literally play this video game. Oh, okay. You've just been lurking. Kind of like I assume Brenton is right now, since this is like one of his favorite games and he hasn't talked to me. How was this button all the way over here? Wait, where was that even? I don't recognize that place. Also, I like how when you're turning like this, you can see like the edge of the, like the water over there, you can see the edge of it. It's like in Minecraft when you see the edge of the world. All right. Oh, what's the point of a door if I can't break it? Oh, that's not what I meant to do. Oh, well, maybe, I guess. That's possible. I hadn't thought of that. I mean, because there is that other one that's outside the level, so... No. I do that. That means you're supposed to do the... There you go. Yes! Haha! Oh, and now a thing. Oh, come to think of it, do I have enough skulls now to... Okay, good. Pressing start does that. A few total saving... No options, huh? Yes, I do. Oh, no, wait. I can't see how many skulls I have. You know what? I'm going to adjust that. Where is the keyboard? There. I'm going to adjust that in the podcasting program, because right now I can't see, like, some dialogue in that thing. And yeah, Pixelhead, you would need to be decent at writing, I suppose. Though really, I tend to degrade more based on ideas than grammar. Definitely on grammar a bit, and I'd help kids who weren't the super best at that, but I'll put it up there. Is that alright with you guys? Oh man, I could like adjust the size and stuff too. I can make myself tiny, or apparently super large. Yes. No. Okay, anyway, I have 10 of those things, so that's nice. Alright, cool. I like this program. It's good. Makes things easy. Alright. Oh no, really? What? But how? I can't get higher than that. That's the highest jump thingy I have. Unless I can double jump from it. No, I can't. What? What even? Oh no. I can try this, but considering these are 2D model thingies, I doubt it's gonna work. Nope, okay. Ow! The things I do for puzzle pieces. Yeah, the gamification was interesting. I never did make it work as well as I wanted to, though. Wait, what was terrible, Aquasin? I mean, I just jumped off the thing, but I don't think... I think you typed that before then, so I'm forgetting what I did that was terrible. Yeah. Oh, no. Well, I'm going to... Well, I don't know. I probably haven't done everything in this area, because this game seems to have a lot of things to do in each area. Hey, no, stop! No! Okay. But I'm not sure what else to do aside from the stupid crab. Oh no, wait, the X! I can do that. Oh no. Oh no, there was a life there I could have gotten. I mean, I'm in desperate need of lives, obviously. Oh, I didn't notice a pun. Thank you. Hey, hey. Bad Kazooie. I was just looking back and trying to see the pun. Go. Yes, okay. Oh, this was probably a bad idea. Okay. Oh, also the chest having eyes makes more sense now. I guess it had a random bit of dialogue that I saw at some point. I don't know if you guys noticed it, but it explained that it was one of Gruntilda's treasure boxes and is gonna protect. Okay, so I need to fly now. Man, if you... Oh, okay. I mean, if... Well, I don't know. Adding verticality to a game that doesn't actually allow... Oh, no! That's... I did it too early. No! Freaking... Dang it. Okay. Adding verticality to a video game where you can only adjust the left and right angling of the camera just seems like a less than stellar idea, but... I'm going to guess that there's another X over here. No? Oh, maybe I actually need to hit each of them, except the... Hey, you know what? You shut up. I don't... Yeah, that was bad. That was really bad. And I suffered the consequences. Oh, it's over there. Rather than wasting feathers on it, I'm just gonna go over here, because I'm a rebel. You can't tell me what to do. It's just gonna direct me to this area, I guess, probably. Oh, then I'll probably need to fly up to that high place, I guess. No, I've been on that high place. But oh my gosh, this is thin! Okay, that was close. Andrew, no, don't do it. Why? Oh, hey, what is... I don't know what that thing is. I want it. It's cute. It's probably gonna kill me. It's a... Aww. Aww, this poor... Poor thing. Where... I mean, I imagine I can find a lot of pebbles around. Well, that just makes me sad, though. Like, he's a bucket. It's all he has to do is... hold water, and he can't do it. I mean, how would you feel if you were created for only one purpose, and then for one reason or another couldn't even do it? That's... Whoosh. Yes, it is, up there. Oh, come on, don't lose altitude. No! Okay, fine. Let's go there. No, seriously? Oh my gosh, I'm the worst at this. I have climbed these boxes entirely too many times. The number of boxes that must be climbed in this game is too damn high. Okay, Oh, come on. I've gotten decent at the jumping things. That was dumb. He could hold rocks or sand. Well, he could hold sand. Kinda. But then, you know, it'd leak out through the hole. He wouldn't be able to hold much sand. Admittedly, sometimes I do like the whole center the camera behind the character thing, because it makes a alignment a little easier. At least when the controls allow it to be. Okay. No! Oh my gosh. The controls are actually pretty decent and fluid, but they're still very... kinda slippy. No! Okay. Okay. Use puzzle piece now? What? What? Oh, what the? Oh my gosh, this island wasn't useless. It was here for more than just the crab. Also, I like how he's like, you'll never find me now, and he's like right down there. You could have at least gone somewhere else. All right. Hey. No. You're not letting me open gently. Yes. Man, if he would have just held still, I could have opened him a lot more. This is taking a... Okay. I'm gonna stop talking about that treasure chest that forced me to open him violently. Seriously, though, there are unfortunate implications out the wazoo about this bear. I don't know. Trap. Oh, well, that would have been smarter on his part, I'm sure. Alright, let's see. How many puzzle pieces do I have now? 9? And I don't really know what else to do here, so I don't know, it'd be great if they would, like, in late game, give me an ability to know the direction of the puzzle pieces or something, like if they're gonna make me get all of them. But for now, I guess I'll head to a different world. I don't know, the hub world is so large that I'm kind of... Me too, cool. Why is she... Is she, like, taunting herself? Like, I don't... Oh, hey! Who was it? I think it was Aquasen who suggested that... That one was in the hub world. And, yeah, you were right. Good job. Oh, that explains that one random thing. This one. I noticed that before and thought that it was kind of weird. I don't know, when he jumps like that, he sounds kind of like Blue from Blue's Clues. I probably just dated myself with that. I mean, I'm not that old, but still. Alright. I guess Blue's Clues is probably still around, but... I don't know. Alright. Another one. Stop eating my puzzle pieces, Kazooie. I hope you get indigestion from them. Alright. Okay. Let's, see what other worlds there are to conquer. Oh! Oh! I can get to that one place that I couldn't before because I didn't know how to do it. Nope. Nope. You're dumb. A long time, huh? Okay. I know that my generation kind of grew up with Blue's Clues, and then they replaced Steve with, like, Joe or whatever, and... My generation just hated it after that. It wasn't the same. It really went downhill after Steve left. It was weird, too, like, especially in hindsight, like, there was all these, like, weird rumors about him. Like, I think he just went off to college or something, but everyone's all like, oh, he got fired because he did drugs or something. It was weird to see how much random... Oh, no, this is gonna be a sewer level, isn't it? Oh. I appreciate that, Mole. Still my favorite character. But anyway, yeah, it was weird how his departure sparked so many... weird rumors? I don't know. Oh my gosh. And then I need to find the actual, like, places, too. Ah! Okay. What's with the frame rate? Stop that. Okay. I'm gonna talk to you again, see what you have to say. Oh, well, I already know this tuna ice cream flavored toothpaste. Is that gonna become important? Like, is this gonna make me remind? Oh, Joe. Oh, man. It wasn't just my generation that got mad about Joe. Yeah, I don't know. I'm sure he wasn't bad at it or anything. I don't know. It was different. And change is hard, I guess. Whee! Oh, and this is probably... Well, no, because that painting's complete. Never mind. I had some sort of brilliant flash of insight, and then it was dumb. So... Well, I still can't get up to that mountain, though. Unless there's a flying block around here. No? Okay. Well, in that case, this is still just confusing. Alright, well... Once more onto the breach, then. Oh no, wait, what was up here? I forget if there was something important. No, stop that. Okay. Oh! I'm gonna hold the thing. I still just will not get enough of that. Well, I will never get enough of that animation. I just find that completely hilarious. What kind of bird is Kazooie, anyway? You know, if they do end up putting Banjo and Kazooie in Smash Brothers, I really want there to be, like, an alternate moveset. Kind of like Sheik and Zelda, where, like, you'd switch, like, your down B is to switch to Kazooie, like this. The combat style's different. Keep it later for your treat. Oh, well, at least that's kind of weird, isn't there? Stupid sharks. Oh! It's probably gonna let me lower the water at some point, I guess. Is there a pipe I can climb or something? Oh, there's a switch! Yes, switches. Red crested. Go and look that up, that's cool. Red crested Breagle, huh? I'm gonna really quick use a laptop here to look that up. I wanna see what that looks like. Breagle. Okay. Oh, given the images I'm finding, I get the impression that they don't exist except for. What? I'm leaving that alone. Okay, well, that's the end of me looking up images for Banjo-Kazooie. The internet, I tell you. Yeah, I got the impression that apparently Breagles were made up for this game. Which would make sense. It's not the only thing they've made up. And boom! Oh. Oh, that makes sense. Okay. So, no lowering water yet, then. Ah! I'll go into here, then. Game system, yeah, okay. Oh, one new move. Great. Oh, so I guess I just fall down. All right. Hello, crab. Boom. Aha. My crab battling skills are excellent. Now can... Okay. I'll try climbing this. I assume I just go up to it. Press A, maybe? Yeah, there you go. Okay, night, Aquasin. Thanks for showing up. Oh, no! Ow! No! Ah! That scared the crap out of me! Okay. Freaking. Ah! Okay, well, now I know not to go in front of those anytime soon. What we need is Banjo-Kazooie 3D. Now. So, you know, I just go here and then... Ah! Out of the... So, get on that, Rare. Just fix your relationship with Nintendo and whatever's wrong. And, a golden feather. Oh my gosh. Oh! Alright. So let's see. It's saying five people are watching, but only one seems to be commenting anymore. I think Andrew's the only one. Oh, okay, nope. Good night! Alright, double jump, yes! Okay. Alright. Oh no! I need to get super close just to make him come out. Okay. That is scary. I mean, clearly this is a horror game. I think we can all agree. Well, what? Okay. Okay. Okay, fine. Alright, well, let's see what else is... We're doing alright on eggs, I think. Okay, there we are. A place to be. Yeah. I don't think I've encountered... You know, I've heard... one song in particular for the- oh, gosh! Nope. 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 Garbage grinder? Okay. I feel like I shouldn't go in there. Okay. I guess he's a nice garbage grinder. Oh no! Alright. Oh, I see a giant fish with big teeth like that, and I don't want to go near it, but alright. I'm trying to think if it did this game save- oh, save and quit. Okay, that makes sense. I hadn't really thought of saving and was concerned. Hoping it auto-saved or something. Alright. Well, it's a surprisingly large game, it seems. Well, like, I don't know, the- even other, you know, similar semi-open world platform games like the Mario games and stuff give a bit more direction. Oh? Must I really? No! 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 Why? I didn't come here looking for a fight. Well, how am I supposed to fight you if that happens? Alright. Meow. Man. Stupid guy's trying to pick a fight. Banjo will always come through. Yes! Double kill. Beaten symptoms. Oh, they are beaten symptoms. Okay. Where's his prize? Really? Okay. Cool. Light? Okay. All right, well, you know. Glad that happened. feathers or whatever. All right. Man, I don't know, like, the underwater controls are fine when you're just using this, you know, slow A button version, but they're so slow. And then you do this and you can't actually direct anything, and it's really confusing. Okay. Oh man, there are a lot of different places I can go. This place is so huge. Alright, well, I'll get up here and get these invulnerability feathers. And then, I think I'm gonna call it night. It's about the time that I was saying I'd be done. And most of my viewers, what, you know, so many viewers I had, seem to have gone off to sleep anyway. Ow! You stupid. So, oh, that's interesting. Do I need to... Nope. Okay, well, I'll, Okay. No. Oh, go over there. That looks interesting. Another stupid pipe eel. This witch does not take very good care of her place. She's letting crazy homicidal eels live in her pipes. Oh, is that really all that... Oh, okay. What? I pressed the button again, you stupid game. Okay, well. In any case, I think this is the point where I'm gonna call it a night for now. Those of you who are still here, if I didn't bore you too much, again, it's my first time doing this, but, I will be continuing through this game on, the next Thursday at the same time, hopefully, you know, actually on time. Tonight got crazy. So, yeah, just for the information of everyone who's been watching, this is, I'm playing through Banjo-Kazooie at the request of a patron. If you have, you know, if there's a game that you love that I haven't played, then, you know, you can feel free to head on to Patreon and donate at the level that allows you to make me play a new game, a classic game for everyone to see. Brenton Stockwell donated and wanted me to play this, so I will continue with this on Thursday, and of course you have the right to tell me what to do as well if you want to, so... Cool, thank you, Andrew. So, yeah, next Thursday at 9, this will happen again. For now, I will sit... Oh, man, you know, I didn't notice the graphic up there of Banjo and Kazooie at the top. They both look very kind of determined and awesome-looking. Though, for some odd reason, the little, well, the crest or whatever on Kazooie looks very pixelated compared to everything else. It's weird. All right. I'll go ahead and... Yes, I am. Thank you, though. So, yeah. All right, I will see all of you guys later. Oh, do I have a... Am I... Does this just happen every time I quit? I've played Fatal Frame before. What? I saved and quit. That's not how this works. Whoa. Well then. Oh. Okay. What? But okay. I suppose I can play Fatal Frame, Andrew, but firstly that is a patron thing, and secondly I have played Fatal Frame before, so it's not, you know, the streaming thing is supposed to be like, if there's a classic I've not played, then you can make me play it, but I suppose I might be able to stretch it. In any case, yeah, Thursday at 9, that's when this will be happening, so I will see all of you later. It was fun, and, Games is Lit 101. I assume all of you know what the show is, but, yeah. See you guys around.